The racket starts going to 6 o'clock. It won't flip. Yeah, if it's not at an angle, when you pull it, it won't flip it down and back. It will just be a shorter stroke. It might be on the hitting side of your body, but if I need the racket to flip. And the only way it flips, it has to be at an angle. Does that make sense? How do you feel today? Good or great? Last time on the forehand, turn sideways, but when you go back, sometimes I tell the kids, you like, I know my hands, up, down, pull, almost like soldier, up, down, pull, so it's like elbow up, elbow extension, pull, but obviously, when you play tennis, you want to have it like a shape, so you have some, but the best way to learn this, at home, to practice, I go like this. See, because that way your brain gets confused. When you flow, the brain goes like this. When you flow, it has a tendency to go that way. Because this is a hinge. Hinge, hinge, hinge. It flows. So sometimes when I have everybody just go like this. Hop, hop, hop. They do it better. Like they're at Taekwondo class. You'll see. Hop, hop. This kid being smooth and relaxed. You're very loose, your muscles. Okay? I'm more concerned about discipline. Up. Yeah. If you take the butt cap and point it right on the dog's head, you'll hit it even harder. Watch it. Unit turn. Put the butt cap straight down on the dog's head. Make sure you got the grip to land properly. Hear that? Up and down. Just go up, down. Okay, that's a good shape. Just put your butt cap down. See, here's the thing. I couldn't even write this in an article. Your dad understands. See, if I wrote this on an article, people think I'm like insane. You know, because it's very much against how, because you're supposed to be smooth and relaxed and flow and have a loop. But your brain, if you did what you were doing, it goes the other way. And if I would say, turn your shoulders and go up, down, the first thing people are going to say is, they don't look natural. They don't look rhythmic. They look tight. They look like robot or whatever. Even some of the guys, when they come here to work here and they first see what I'm doing, they do not understand. But your dad can see on the last one, when you went up, down, two things happened. Number one, she went right to 5:30 or 5 o'clock. The stroke was shorter. And two, the racket head was above the wrist. And three, it made you pull the racket and not pre-roll. So you corrected three things with doing that. Now, you don't see Federer out there or any of these guys going, you know, playing like that. But you're not going to do that either. But if I can get that neighborhood groove, you'll go. You'll smooth it out. Does that make sense? Through everything that I've said, your forehand got a lot better. Then the pass. Before it was a hamburger. Now you're a cheeseburger. Okay, we're trying to get up here to a filet. How's that? I'll give you a C. I want an A. That's a B. If you go down hard, I bet you hit a bullet. Watch it. It's so funny. You know, when I say hard, see, when I said hard, she went like this. She went this way first to go that way. You're going to turn down. Tommy! Tommy! Ready? Up. Down. There it is. Did she do that last time where she went that way first?
No.
See, when she goes like that. She goes this way to go that way. No. Hey, you don't need that. This isn't like ballroom dancing or something like that. You don't need that. Just, all you do is turn. You ready? See how she goes that way? Ready position. Just turn. Good. Ready? Up, down. Go down harder. Up. Better. Better so. Up, down. Awesome. Up, down. Now go down as hard as you know. Those are all good. Down. Yeah, I'm even more so right about how loose you are. See, she doesn't need to go that way first. It's just. Your left hand, or the non-dominant hand, then let go. Your left hand's your best friend, okay? How good is that? Put on. And you should keep the left hand on that. You should keep it on until you're turned all the way. Go ahead and turn. See how she let go? I don't want her to do that. Watch, I'll show you Rafa, better. I'm not telling you to do it because they do it. I'm telling you to do it because this is the best way to do it. Watch my left hand. See, I got it on to here. I'm not saying it's wrong. If you're running forward, obviously you'd let go of the racket. But just the meat and potatoes of the ground stroke. Keep it on there, then let go. She doesn't let go until it gets to that 90 degree angle. Deal? That's really important. Not only will it help you turn your shoulder and your hip, which most of the girls don't do far enough, it will also keep you a little more compact. Because if you let go too soon, especially when you're little, whee, goes all over Oregon, Portland, it goes everywhere. Keep your left hand on the rack. Better. Get that unit turn all the way. Now, no, no, watch this. Her left hand, set it. Your left hand should be here. Whether she holds on with her fingertips or at rest, it doesn't matter. But left hand on the throat.
Ready.
Push the butt cap down. Sit down. Good. Ready. Unit turn. Good. And watch this. So do this. Show. Let's do it together. See that I look a little more locked in. And I'm all for being free and relaxed, but you don't need that. That's not going to be your issue. Mentally relaxed. Up, down, put the butt cap hard on the dog's head. Back up a little bit. Here we go. Ready? You got your hand up there, right? Good. So this is going to be a tough one. This is going to be a tough one. That's good, that's good. A lot of times when I feed it deeper, when the kids go back, then they go back farther. That was good. Just think up, down. Up, down, beautiful. Ready? Up, down. That was great. No. Now, mentally, whether you do that or it goes in by an inch, you can't like live and die with each shot. If you hit it in the net or you hit it out of bounds, you got 20 seconds to get that back in your head. I'm ready to fight. I know you want to get every ball in, but let me tell you this, this is a fact. That ain't gonna happen. It ain't gonna happen. You understand? Learn from. And you put the butt cap down real hard, I'm happy. Very good. You got this hand on the rack, right? Very good. Very good. I like it. I like it. So up. I'm a little concerned about her going like this first, the other way. Can you see? Can you, so you're done. You don't need to go this way with your racket. Do you realize you're doing that? No? Yeah. Okay. So all you do is turn. Yeah. shoulder. Now go down the racket. Go down harder. You already got the shape. Okay, again, here we go. It's all good. Show me 5 o'clock. Where is it at? 5:30. 3 o'clock. Good. Ready position. Up, down. Push the butt cap down hard. Ready? Push the butt cap down hard. Again. You're doing great. You're doing great. Okay. Give me some feedback. Give me some, what that means. Just give me, tell me what you think. Oh, wait. Before that. Do it the way you were doing it 20 minutes ago. Put your hand off the handle. And go ahead and put it back and pet the dog. Feel the same? No, it wasn't no. It was no. Not, okay, how did it feel different? You can say whatever you want. You can say better, worse, same.
I pushed the dog.
Huh? So you could feel a difference? See everything I just said. There's a lot that I just said there in like 20 minutes, but these are the details that separate maybe someone having a great stroke opposed to good. Does that make sense? The good thing, we got it all on tape, but you got to still, when she plays a match, a lot of this isn't going to happen. But you need to take your time, your dad can feed you the balls, whatever, and just discipline, discipline, discipline. Now, I want you to hit 10 balls holding the racket right there. No, I see that face you're giving me. Trust me, you'll hit it just as good. You might even hit it better. I know you're going, don't give my dad any ideas. Great, that's exactly what I wanted to see. Just turn the racket over. Okay, now, other than different, what's it feel like? What'd you feel like with your feet? The same or different? Or you couldn't tell? Okay, that's okay, whatever you want to say. What'd it feel like with this stroke? Did you feel more organized or less organized? Less organized. She's thinking of it because I don't like it so much. Whatever you say, I'm going to disagree with. Water. Grab a drink. Grab quick, get a quick drink. You might want to come over here, Dad. Uh-huh. This arm, I want. See, she has what we call a double bend. See how this is both bent? You got two chicken wings. All right? You know you like chicken. I want you to take this, and it should be like this. Watch this. Straight. So, yeah, really. Just trust me on this, okay? Listen, I've had so many people, their backhands are amazing. You can't even imagine. So, this is going to be straight. But none of them do it like Djokovic, and that's what I'm going to show you. So this is going to be straight. This will be a little bent, like her coach in Oregon has said. But watch this. So you don't want it so bent that, look, there's a crevice between her hand and the handle. So think about it. You think it'd be optimal. See how there's like space? You want this flush on the handle. So right off the bat, and I know when she swings, it does come back to the handle. So right off the bat, the grip would be on there. So when we say bent, watch, it's a cause and an effect. Look, when this goes up, look what it does to the hand. It comes off the handle. So now it's flush on the handle. Is that bent? It's still bent. See what I mean? So when people say bent, it's like, okay. And like Djokovic, okay, or any of these guys, I'm going to show you. Right arm straight, left elbow bent, racket head above the wrist. The racket's at like 6:30 on the hitting side. Like the clock is different now. So you were like this. She was here and here. And then you would do a bubble loop and then do your stroke. And it goes in because you're a good athlete. Okay, so we're gonna change this. Turn sideways. So right off the bat, the right arm is straight. The grip with the right hand is correct. It's like what we call continental. This is a semi-western, I can live with that. But what we're gonna do, Soph, is this. I'm gonna feed her the ball, and what you're gonna do, I want her waiting like this. And then you're gonna, it's almost like you're a left-handed baseball player. Does that make sense? Now, if the ball comes faster, not now, but in the future, you might not have enough time to set the racket, so it goes like this, joke of it. The ball comes fast. The hands are around the pelvis, that means the waist area. See, it's all on this side of the body, but he didn't set the racket. But normally, well, he didn't have time. You know, it comes so fast. See, I had to make it continuous. He couldn't set it. But if they have time, here's what they'll do, or here's what you should do. You should turn the shoulder immediately, set it. Now watch. You pull with the right arm, and then you push with the left. But look. Look at Rick's backhand. Look. Now, you ready? The Oregon special. Here's what you did. You went like this. You went like that. And you went. Now, the Rick special. Now, you tell me which one would be better playing Wimbledon on grass when the ball comes 70 miles an hour. That's the problem. Everybody has to make adaptations. And I'm not saying it don't work. Listen, yeah, if you hit a billion of anything, it's going to get better. But some of these guys, it looks so easy. So I got to put simplicity. What's up? I got to put simplicity into you. So just wait like that. As long as that's straight, a little bend. Because see, this is straight, and that's bent. And when she swings, it's going to go like this. Ready? I don't want to go too deep here, but I'm just... So you're just going to pull with your right, push with your left. Do everything you were doing before, but you're going to be waiting there for that. Ready, position. So you got to get all the way back to your dad. Okay, time out. She's very army, set it. And on the two-handed backhand, it's such a unit to that. Don't do that anymore. This has to go. It's such a unit. What I mean by that, it's really the body pulls the arm so much through the stroke. It's not an arm shot. See, her backhand has been hit totally with her arm. So, basically, so it's like this. Now, what I want you to do, just pivot your body as hard as you can and don't swing. Pivot. Do that.
Look the other way.
That was awesome. That was awesome. Get all the way back to your dad, where your dad's at. That's where the racket is. All I want you to do is just pivot the body. Don't swing. You took the racket back. Don't swing the racket. I got to go about this differently. Now, I mentioned something about the grip from your dad. I mentioned something about the grip. You got to make sure that your hand is there and don't have it like this. Like your serve grip. This right hand is your serve grip. Is that how you do your serve? And I'm going to change your other hand. We might not even get to the serve today, so I don't know what's cooking. Sorry, I know. Well, I'll try. All I want you to do is there's a lot of little things here. All I want you to do is just turn your body. Don't swing.
Turn anybody. Turn anybody.
But you turn your body as hard as you can. It's like you're throwing tennis a ball. How fast can you turn? One interesting. Get it back. You're done. All you do is just turn. Don't swing. But you can swing even harder. Watch this. This freaks everybody out. Watch this. Thing is, forget this stuff for a second. If the ball was coming fast, because to me this is all about tomorrow, not today. If it's coming fast, you can see I can just go boom. Because you're gonna want to hit on the rise. So I gotta get her out of the habit of using her arms. First off, the technical part was a little messed up, but you're hitting it with the arms, yeah, because you're very easy.
No.
Get all the way back. See how it's on the edge? Now pivot your body as hard as you can. Don't swing. Very good. So I'm going to go about doing this like this. Just pivot. That's it. Fine. Overcook it. Fine. Get it back. All you do is pivot. Pivot. Again. Go. Just pivot. Show me how fast you can snap your hips. Get it back. Snap. question. Does this feel like your old backhand?
Yeah.
See, basically, I don't want to, it's a little more complicated. I was going to show her the technical part, but I got to go back to almost like the basics. You're not using the body. See, when you hit a two-handed backhand, because two hands are on the racket, it's even more so than this side. See, the bigger muscles, look, the body pulls the racket and then it loosens up, where she was doing everything with the arms. So I got all kinds of corrective techniques to make this better. Just get it back, stretch it back as far as you can to your dad. And just pivot, don't even swing. Again, there's a girl, I don't know if she'll be here today, she just came back from Brazil. She's like 10 in the world, ITF, okay, her backhand, not good at all. And all I've been trying to tell her, or tell Jason to tell her, don't even swing at the ball. Because she does this. Take the racket. It works, but no juice. And I just told her to go like this. She goes, I never hit a ball that hard in my life. And she's 15. And she's 10 in the world. She's number one in the United States. But her backhand's not good. But she has good slice. So, you can... Huh? Her forehand's good. Okay, but my point is... It's a package. At the end of the day, you want everything solid. You know what I mean? I mean, her backhand's okay, but it's not like there's 400 girls out there and their backhand's better, even if she's a better player than those 400 girls, because she does it wrong. And you're going down that same path because you've got to use your body. If she just, watch that, here's what I want you to do, okay? I just want her to get it back as far as she can for now. Forget all this stuff I said, Peter. And turn her body as hard as she can and follow through. Don't swing at the ball. Here we go. Here, watch this. Watch this. But don't even, but she'll just turn on the ball. And then her arm, she'll hit the ball. She can hit the ball 50 miles an hour. She's 12 years old. See? It's like you're shoveling snow, you're throwing a medicine ball. Okay, she's been throwing it with her, she's doing it with her arms. So I got to go right to the basics, the concepts. Don't use your arms. And how do I do that? Don't even swing, and you'll do it. Ready? Ready position. Stretch it back. Stretch it back, stretch it. But if your arms are bent,
вверх. Дочь, ты уронила опять. Держи вверх.
I can put so much more into this. I'll show you how to turn the racket over, get top spin, but I gotta get her to understand the bigger muscles bring the racket. The body's the car, the racket's the passenger. You gotta pull it. See, before she was swatting at it. It's all good. You're doing great. Don't worry about anything other than pivot. Can you pivot faster? Tip it hard. Just turn. Don't even swing. Good. Doesn't matter. Good. Now, if you played like that and someone saw you, they'd say, hey, you got to loosen up. You got to get more topspin. But, and your dad knows what I'm trying to do here, but the core fundamentals of the body bringing the racket is correct. Now, what you have to do is this. The body brings a racket, hopefully a little low to high, and then once the racket gets to here, the arms release. See, but the igniter, but the beginning was done correctly, where before she did her arms first. Does that make sense? Do a break, stretch it back. Awesome. Question. Does this feel like your old backhand? No. How does it feel different? Whatever you say is fine. Okay, you're popping. Now think about it. Okay, well, let's just go to the popping. What she is doing, she's describing what an athlete feels. She says it's popping. Now think about it. Here I am telling you, turn sideways, get it all the way back, don't swing at the ball, and she's saying she's popping it. See, which is good. What you said is right, because it's jumping off your racket. It's not what we call manufacture. Give me a couple of minutes. You gotta get it, sir. You're done. You're done. That's all. Not done, done, done. You just get it back. Look. See, everybody, first off, most people can't identify what people do wrong, and then they don't even teach it right. Okay, watch. Now watch. Look. Yeah, I just turn the body. It's like a hockey shot. The body pulls the ball. Can you keep the racket on the hitting side? Yeah, you're doing great. Quick drink, sir. So, okay, if I had her start from there, what was she doing? What was, because very seldom do I see that, what was she doing wrong before? Was she externally rotating something? Is that what was going on?
Yeah.
Okay. So do the whole serve. The whole serve. Is hearing about a brand new crash on Flagler Street, right at 92nd Avenue, beginning at the Jenkins up on that road. Then a minor crash reported on 95 still externally reported. Okay. Should be off to the side. One more. We also have a collision in Golden Blades on the Pamela Eastbound ramp to 95 northbound. That's off to the side. It's just on the traffic. Very athletic. AT&T has a network with thousands of best-in-class security experts helping protect from a security breach, which means more security experts like this. Okay, here's what we got to do. Okay, last time you were here, did I have you put the racket down the back? Probably not.
No.
Okay, here's what happened. Okay, first off, when she does the wind-up, there's external rotation, which I told you and your dad. What that means, you go back, the racket opens up a little bit. People at home are going to tell you, like, frying pan, waiter, like you have a pizza in your hand. The problem is, you can do this till you're 24 years old. I mean, there's this crap on the tour, yeah. Not with the men. Don't put that on YouTube. No, with the women. I see this a lot. Even if it's 5% to 20%. Hers opens up 30% at least. So here's what you want to do. Set the racket. Up. No, not like that. We're going to change it. You're ready for this. Now, from right there, all we want to do, Dad, is have this go like that. That's all I want you to do. No. You're going to, you don't need to do that anymore. I know why I did what I did. Now, I might change it, but I want to see what you do. So from here, you just go like this. Just swing it. Watch. See where I'm at? Watch. See, what I got to do, so set it. What I got to do is this. Set your record. Watch, buddy. See, what I got to do, yeah, this is all going to change. I got to make sure. This is called the edge. The edge goes in. The edge goes down, it flares out. Now her shoulder set up at what we call internal rotation. To come back, bang. So from a back, from a back. It's just a fantastic place to go. But when you talk about Vera Cadillac View and GMC, it's not just the prices. Beyond that, it's the way you treat it. So, go. Yeah, that's over with. You're going to have this in line with the shoulder, and I want it a little bit in. So you just go like this. Just swing it. Whatever happens naturally, then I can react accordingly. Go. She's already starting to go that way. Better. So you can have it just like that. Just like if you had an axe, not that you would throw an axe, just throw an axe. Throw the axe. This is all I want you to do. And here's what happened. She's in the camp, right?
Yes.
So make sure, like, if people are, like, they're telling you things, you might have them come to me, because this is a little tricky, because everybody's going to tell her what to do, which they're all going to know what to do, but what I'm telling her is what she has to do, like, right now to correct the problem.
Mm-hmm.
So, and I'll tell them also.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. Just throw the, all I want her to do is throw the edge of the racket, throw the edge of the racket at the sky. That's all we're working on right now. You got it? And you're going to start like this for now. Does that make sense? Throw the edge of the racket. It doesn't matter if it's down or back too soon. Go, go. That doesn't matter. None of that matters.
What should I do for vacation?
I like that. Just like throw the edge of the racket to the sky. Good.
Do they sail from around here?
Hey. So, you know what the edge of the racket is, right? You know what the sky is, right? That's all I care about. Go.
Come on,
this guy thinks I'm a knucklehead. Go. Hey, I gotta check in. You never know. Go. Edge of the sky. That's all I want.
Hey,
that's at the net. To me, look. To me, the edge of the racket at the sky. Why don't you go to Sweet or the Haven and get
outside? You're a genius.
You said that's the sky. Throw the edge of the racket at the sky. She'll probably hit it in. Okay, where's the edge of the racket? Go. Go. Here we go. Throw the edge of the sky. Better. We're going to learn how to get up and out. Yeah, it's okay. No, no. We got. So it's going to be like this. Because look, it's better, rotting. It doesn't matter. They're coming into their backswing. Enjoy our delicious new citrus marinated crispy boil bites trophy chop with a drink for just $5.99. New crispy boil bites. Only at Boil Tropical. See how the racket's coming in?
How are you, Jim?
I did it. Hi, T30. I'm doing good.
You mean you're doing well?
This genius robot has been 30 years in the making, just like the new Florida Tiger.
All I want.
Cash scratch from the Florida Lottery. We're celebrating 30 years of winning.
Guys, watch, go. If she throws the edge of the racket, see, this is good. If you throw the edge of the racket at the sky, she won't hit it in the net. Watch. Just throw the edge of the racket at the sky. Sky. Again. It's all good, so this is how we're going to get it. I'm not even worried about where this is. So it's going to go like this. Watch, Dad. Look. See the edge? What should happen? But we got to start her a little bit at this angle, so hopefully she won't go that way. Does that make sense? Here we go. Edge of the sky. Edge of the sky. 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 You're doing great. Sky. All good. It's all good. It's all good. Let's go. Sky. That feel like your serve? Trust me. Go. Go. We're rolling now. We're rolling. Rolling. Make sure there's a V. See how there's a V? Mm-hmm. You could have a continental grip and still have a circle.
Mm-hmm.
So you see a V? Like the letter V, right? Okay, that gives more flexibility.
It's a little crooked.
But here I am talking more flexibility in her hand, where the first thing I said on the forehand, I don't want it that loose. So look, it's like this. I never done that. It's okay. Listen, in 40 years, I've only broken like 2 wrists doing that.
So, what?
Yeah, well, it could be 3, but only 2, that's not very many. 40 years. Go. No, not really. Go. Hit it at the sky. Just hit it at the sky. Sky. You're doing great. Now, hit it at the sky towards that guy. That guy in the red hat. No, no. At the sky over his head. Sky over his head. Go. Yeah, that's where I want to aim. Go. Just trust me. At the sky that way. Go. If you hit him, go. I got churn. Go. Put the racket up here. Thanks to him. Go. So you're going to aim at the sky over his head. It'll probably go right in the box. Go. Hit the guy. Sky towards the guy. Go. Sky. graphically something. So if you've got to go like this, the edge has to go down. So the butt cap ends up being like that. Edge. Okay. But you're doing great, but I want it at this side. Where's that guy over here? Go. Edge. Edge. Okay, here's what she has to change. Go. Sophia, go. See, I told her, no. I told her to hit it at the guy because I need her to change the angle of the wrist. But she thought I need to get more power, so immediately she put the racket like that again.
Mm-hmm.
So you got to go like this.
Sophia, look.
You got to go edge, 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 high-five the giant. See, the racket doesn't open up. The racket doesn't open up till contact. You go edge in, edge out, edge up. Set the racket. Ready? Edge. It's okay. It's all good. Z, what time you play?
Today 3.
Huh?
Today 3.
What, because the guy at school?
Yeah.
Edge. No. See how the racket opened up? Kiddo, you have to trust the process. Okay. Now, if I have her start from here, go ahead. She'll probably do it even easier. Yeah. We might have to do that. No, we might have to do that because when I give you a little wiggle room, you did the external rotation. And listen, I can't have that happen when you're practicing. So maybe we just start from here. Okay? Throw the edge out. That's all I want her to do. That's all I want you to do. Just start from there. It's all good. Up. You'll do great. Great. Can you aim towards the back end? Aim right here. I want you to aim. What's up, buddy? Do you get my text? Yeah. Send your sister an email. It's a classic. You got to read it. Drinking fountain.